my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be doing something different. I'm going to be showing you the two ways to achieve the Google Pixel look on a standard, non-rooted Android device. First up, I've got the Google Launcher, which is Google Launcher 3, which is a port of the Android O Pixel Launcher. Now this is in version 1.5, which I will link below the video for you guys to download. So just to show you that all the functionality works on this device, I'm going to be showing you firstly the Google Now card, swipe left to right to achieve it. As you will see, if we swipe left, from left to right we get the Google cards. And if I scroll up, we'll get all your Google cards. So everything is there. Secondly, we're going to look at the swipe up functionality for the app drawer. You can see, it looks exactly like the Pixel Launcher does. All the icons, everything, functionality and the layout, all the same. Icons, same icons you get on the Google Pixel Launcher, the Google Poll works, as well as the weather works. Weather functionality is fine. I'll tap on it and we get to the weather. Google Pixel Poll works as well. As you can see, it works there fine. So that's the first way. Now the way to do this one is by installing the launcher. So I'm going to show you firstly how we're going to do that. So let's get to the rootless Pixel Launcher from Reddit. I'm going to go in there and you will see that this is a whole write-up done on this Pixel Launcher for rootless phones. And we'll see, everything is there, shows you a compiled APK. It also shows you the last time it was edited, which was done on the 17th of June. Now, I know that's some time back, but nonetheless, it is there. So I'm going to tap on that. Let's just open up that link and you will see rootless Pixel Launcher 1.5, and you're going to be downloading the Launcher 3 AOSP Debug APK. Now I've already downloaded it before, so I'm not going to re-download that now again. So let's go ahead and show you guys how to do the install. So let's go to my APK and you will see Launcher 3. Install it and it's as simple as that. Once installed, you're done. You will go back and you will set it as your default launcher for your device. Now this does not include the tap and hold functionality for the shortcuts as you would get in the Google Pixel. That only works if your device is on 7.1 Android. If you're running below that, you're not going to get the functionality. So that's the first way that we can get the Google Pixel look on our phones. The second way is through Nova Launcher. Now I'm going to show you Nova Launcher. Alright, let's tap on Nova Launcher and here we go. Nova Launcher is all set up already. I've pre-installed it, I've pre-set it up, and it's also got the Google functionality cards, swipe left to right. However, there is a little APK add-on you need to install to get this functionality working on this device. Once again, you don't have to be rooted. Just to show you that everything looks similar and everything works the same as the Launcher 3 that I had previously, you will see swipe up for the app drawer. Colors is a bit different, but I mean, with Nova Launcher you can set the functionality. You've got so much customization available. You can change the look and the colorization of your app drawer. So let's just go back down, right? And with Launcher 3, like I said, you don't have the functionality of tap and hold for shortcuts. However, on Nova Launcher you do, and I'll show you. As you can see, we've got that working there. So how do we install and how do we get this working on our devices? Firstly, you're gonna have to install Nova Launcher Beta, which is available through the App Store. You will go down and you will sign up to be a beta user. Secondly, you're going to need to install the little APK device on the little APK onto your device, and I'll show you how to get that. Let's just go into APK Mirror and we're going to scroll all the way to the bottom. Let's just get in here and over here. Nova Google Companion 1.0. You can install that, or download it rather, and install it. You can see we'll just download the APK. Now I've pre-downloaded already, so I'm not going to download it back in. So let's exit this here and let's go to our files, and we need to go to our APK folder. As you can see, com.teslacoil launcher client proxy 1. We tap on that. We're going to install. Once installed, you will have the full functionality of the Google Now cards. Swipe left to right as you would on your Google Pixel. Now, getting the Nova Launcher Pro is going to cost you a bit of money, but I mean, it's full worth it. You got full customization. Everything works fine on it. Let's go back to Nova Launcher. You've got full customization, so go back into settings and show you. We've got desktop settings, we've got app and widget drawers, we've got dock folders. You can do lots of changes, and we're now in Nova Launcher Prime 5.3, by the way. So your customization is way more than any other launcher, and for those that want customization and want to add more icons to our dock, more refined icons, more different icon looks, Nova Launcher allows you to install different icon packages, which is downloadable from the App Store. Now, for Nova Launcher to give me the Google Pixel look, I've got the Pixel icon package, which I downloaded from the App Store. And once you install that, you just set, you're going to your Nova Launcher settings, and you're just going to do, let's just do this for you guys. That's the wrong one. We need to go back up. Back into Nova Launcher, and we're going to go to settings, and we're going to look and feel, and you're going to choose your icon theme. So the Pixel icon pack would be the one that you want. Put the icon theme pack, Pixel icon pack, which is downloadable from the Play Store. Once you've downloaded, choose it, and it will give you the whole Pixel icon look on your device. Now, as I said, with Nova Launcher comes full customization. And just to show you guys, you can set the folder preview, the folder background, transition windows. You can even set on night mode, your gesture inputs, and obviously the Google Now section, which allows you for the Google Now page, edge swipe, swiping on the edge of the home screen to reveal Google page, etc. is all there. And if we go into the section here, we can see if there's any updates for the icon pack and as well as the Google Companion. So with the new release 1.1, we now have support for Lollipop. So if you're on Lollipop and you've got Nova Launcher, you can download this and will work on your device. So let's just download that again. Okay, and that should be functioning now. So like I said, Nova Launcher has got way more customization available for you guys, which will work fine. Now, coming back to the Launcher 3, which is the one I've got on my phone as my default, we've also got the wallpapers that work from the icon, from the Google Pixel launcher, which was ported. See, we've got all the wallpaper functionality, we've got live wallpapers, but I don't have any at the moment. So that's working. The widgets work. And as I showed you, settings work. So that's the two ways to get the Google Pixel look on your device, running 5.1 or 6 and above. And if you want the tap and hold for shortcuts, you need to be on 7.1 using Pixel Launcher 3. However, if you have Nova Launcher on your device, you don't need to have 7.1. And as you saw now, we've got functionality for Lollipop for the Google Now cards. On the first page, swipe left to right. As you will see, we go left to right, and we've got that functionality there. So if you are on Lollipop now on your device, you'll be able to have the Google Now cards on your device as the first home page. If you're running 5.1 or 5, and you've got Nova Launcher, download the Nova Launcher Companion. I will link everything down below for you guys to download. And as usual, like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Cheers, thanks for watching.